Last time we have studied about the reconstitution of partnership. Now today I am starting a very important topic, that is goodwill. Goodwill actually is an intangible asset. The problem is that how to calculate the value of goodwill. Value, because it is intangible asset, that's why it is very difficult to calculate the value of goodwill. Generally, there are three methods by which we can calculate goodwill. First is average profit method. Average profit. In this, what we have to study that how to calculate the value of goodwill. Three methods. Later on I will explain the second and third as well, the super profit and capitalization method as well. But today, average profit method first. How to calculate average profit method? By the help of example, I will explain this average profit method. Suppose there is a firm. In 2011, profit of a firm was 50,000. 2012, this is the profit. Suppose 20,000 loss. 2013, 70,000 profit. 2014, 80,000 profit. And 2015, suppose 40,000 profit. This is the question. Now we have to calculate the average profit method. First of all, we have to add this 50,000. This is the loss, so we have to minus 70,000 plus 80,000 plus and 40,000 plus. These all 4 years we got profit and 1 year we got loss. So we are doing the minus. First of all, plus means this is 80,000. See, 70,000, 40,000. And 50,000. These all are profit. We are adding this 2,40,000. From the 2,40,000, we are deducting 20,000 loss. So we are getting 2,20,000 profit. So how many years this is? 5. So we are dividing by 5. 5 fours are 22. 5 fours are 20 and 3. 44,000 is the average. Simple. This is the average profit method. And if in the question it has written to multiply by the number of year purchase, whatever the number of year purchase it has written in the question, we have to multiply this by, suppose 2 year purchase. So 2 year purchase means 44,000 multiplied by 2, then this is 88,000. So this is the actual value of goodwill by average profit method. It is very simple. We are doing this way, and the next topic Next topic is super profit method. Before super profit method, here in this average profit, there is a weighted average profit also. Next time, I will explain the weighted average, then super profit. Thank you. Now, second topic, weighted average profit method. Weighted average profit method. How to calculate the value of goodwill by the help of weighted average profit method. Simple average profit method that I already explained. Now, weighted average profit. This is also I am explaining by the help of one example. 2011, suppose profit is 43,000. This is the profit. 2012, 50,000 profit. 2000 means one year we are taking the profit, means suppose 52,000 profit. 5 years we are taking, as suppose this is a question that I am telling you, 65,000 profit. And in the last year, suppose 85,000 profit. All our profit. So all we have to add. We have to add. Same as we did in the simple average profit method. We have to add this. If we add this, these are the profit. Now, before adding, there are weight also given in the question. Suppose 2011, one weight is there. 2012, two weight. 2013, three. 2014, four. And 2015, five. So by the help of weighted average profit, we have to add by the weight, first of all, to get the product. Product, how we got? First we have to multiply. Multiply by the weight. 2011, weight is 1, so we are multiplying 43,000 into 1. 2012, weight is 2, so we are multiplying by 2. In 13, 3, in 14, 4, and in 15, 5. This way, we are getting the product. Product we have to calculate first. So 43,000, when we multiply by 1, we got the product same as 43,000. Now 50,000 by 2, we got the product 1 lakh. Now by 3, 1,56,000. 52,000 into 3, and 65,000 when we are multiplied, 2,60,000 we are getting. We are multiplied, 5, 6 are 30, 3, 5, 6 are 24, or 2, 26. 2,60,000 we are getting. Now, by 5 when we multiply, 4,25,000. When we multiply this by 5. Now 9,84,000 is the total of this product. This is the profit, and we are multiplying by the profit and weighted, and when we multiply, we got product, and we add this product, and the total of this product is 9,84,000. Number of years now means how many numbers of years? Means 5. But the weight, now last time we added the number of years, this time we have to add the weight total is 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total is 15. So, 9,84,000 product that we got, we have to divide by 15. Means, total weight we have to divide. When we divide, we got 65,600. 65,000. When we divide by 15 to 9,84,000, we got 65,600. You can multiply this. And afterwards, how many year of purchase it has given in the question? So, suppose 2 or 3, whatever, we have to multiply. Suppose 2 is given, so 1,31,200 will come by year of purchase that we have to multiply. This is the way that we calculate the weighted average profit. Thank you. Next is super profit method. After this, only one is left, that is capitalization method. That also I will explain. Now, super average, we have finished. Simple average and weighted average, you understand. Now, the super profit method. How we calculate super profit method? What is super profit method? Means, whatever the excess money, whatever the excess money earned by any firm, actual profit and more than actual profit, that is called super profit. More than actual profit. Suppose capital invested in the business, suppose 1 lakh. And the normal rate of earning, normal rate of earning is suppose 15%. So the profit is 15,000. 15,000 profit will come. Simple. But here, suppose actual profit, suppose firm earns 25,000. So 25,000 that profit earned by a firm, we have to deduct the normal profit. Normal profit is 15,000. So 10,000 that the amount is coming, that is called super. That is only the super profit. Means the excess money earned by a firm. Means excess money, that normal rate is given 15%. So whatever the capital invested by a firm, we have to calculate the percentage wise, 15. So that we are getting 15,000 profit. And if the firm is earning more than 15,000, whatever the amount a firm is earning more than 15,000, that we call super profit. That is only the super profit. Now, here one thing you should know, that super profit method that we are earning, so we should know about the normal profit that I have explained how we are calculating the normal profit by percentage. Normal profit. And next is super profit. Super profit, that the actual profit we are deducting from actual profit we are deducting the normal profit, we are getting the super profit. Now, how to calculate main thing by this method is goodwill. Super profit is coming, you know, the excess money that I have explained. Now, how to calculate the goodwill? Goodwill, super profit into number of year purchase. whatever the super profit coming into number of year purchase, always that we did in the last time question also we did, means suppose here super profit is coming 10,000, that we explained here 10,000 is super profit. Super profit 10,000. Number of years suppose 3 is given, so goodwill is 30,000. If 2 is given, then 20,000 will come. 5 is given, then 50,000 will come. Simple, we have to multiply by number of year purchase. So from the whole thing is that average profit, simple average, weighted average, super profit. Last topic that remain is capitalization method. Now the next topic we will understand in the last term. Just thank you all. Next topic is capitalization of average profit. Average profit you already understood, that I have explained. Now before that capitalization of average profit, I want to explain you the formula of capitalization of average profit. We are calculating the goodwill. How to calculate? So by the help of capitalization of average profit into 100 upon normal rate of return. This is the formula that you have to bug up to calculate the capitalization of average profit for goodwill. Now, with the help of one example, I am trying to explain you capitalization of average profit. Suppose actual profit of a firm is given 72,000. Normal rate of return 10%, suppose it has been. Assets and liabilities also given. What is assets and liabilities? I am just explaining you. Suppose 970,000 assets and 4 lakh liability. In the 11th class you already done, when we minus liabilities from assets we got capital. So when we minus 970,000, that is assets and liabilities that we are minus, we will get capital. That is very compulsory. Now, average profit here is 72,000. It has given in the question. In 200 upon normal rate, that is 10%. This is the formula that I have put. By calculating this, we got 7,20,000. And by capital employed, sometimes in the question, capital employed is given. So no problem in that. If assets and liabilities are given, so assets minus liabilities means 9,70,000 minus 4,00,000, 5,70,000 will come, and that is capital employed. Now 7,20,000 we got, and 5,70,000 is the capital employed. Now we can calculate goodwill. Last thing means how 7,20,000 minus 5,70,000, that is capital employed. 1,50,000. 1,50,000 50,000 will come, and that is good. So capitalization of average profit, we got goodwill. First, what we did, let me explain. This is the formula: average profit into 100 upon normal rate. As actual profit is given 72,000, 72,000 normal rate, this 10% assets and liabilities are given. 72,000 is the average profit, and that is given, and into 100 upon 10, that will come 7,20,000. From 7,20,000, now the next thing that we have to calculate, that is capital employed, assets minus liabilities, we got capital employed. And when we calculate goodwill, 7,20,000 minus what is capital employed, goodwill. Rest of the amount will come is of goodwill. This is the way that by capitalization of average profit we calculate goodwill. Thank you.